Welcome to the tutorial on high frequency response of common source amplifier. In order to determine the gain or the transfer function of the amplifier at high frequencies, what we do is we consider the common source amplifier circuit and we replace it with its high frequency model. So the figure that is seen here is the common source amplifier circuit, and here all the capacitors that are connected, that is the capacitor CC1, capacitor CC2, which are the coupling capacitors, and the capacitor, that is the bypass capacitor CS, will act like a short circuit when we consider the high frequency model. So the equivalent of this circuit is shown here, wherein we have considered the capacitors as short circuit. So you cannot observe the coupling capacitors and the bypass capacitor here. So this circuit can be further simplified by utilizing the Thevenin's theorem at the input side by combining the three parallel resistances at the output side. So you have the resistances, that is the three parallel resistances denoted as R0, RD and RL, and we are going to combine all the three parallel resistances and denote it as RL dash. So by using the Thevenin's theorem, we obtain the equivalent Thevenin's voltage as V signal dash and the resistance here as R signal dash, which is a parallel combination of R signal and RG. The capacitance CGS is maintained as it is. You have CGD, which is maintained as it is. The current GM into VGS is maintained as it is, whereas the three parallel resistances is simplified to RL dash. So this is basically a simplified circuit. This is a simplified circuit, and it can be further simplified if we consider the CGD to be absent, which connects the output node to the input node. So first we will consider the output node, and for the output node, the load current is equal to GMVGS minus IGD, where this GMVGS is the output transistor current and IGD corresponds to the current that is supplied by CGD. So at high frequencies, I have considered the simplified circuit, and this is closer to that of FH, the frequency FH, that will define the edge of the midband. And the value of IGD, that is this value, is very small when compared to GM into VGS, that is the transistor current. So I can compute the output voltage as the output current multiplied with the resistance, output resistance RL dash. So I have minus GM into VGS into RL dash, and RL dash is actually the parallel combination of R0, RD and RL that we have seen here. Now since output V out is equal to VDS, that is because this is a common source amplifier, so this is a drain to source, so V out is equal to VDS, so I can write this as IGD to be equal to S CGD VGS minus V naught. So because VGS is present and V naught is present, V naught can be substituted with minus GM into VGS into RL dash. So that is why we obtain this equation number 3. Important thing to be noted here is that this equation 1 will indicate the gain from the gate to the drain, which is equal to minus GM into RL dash, and the same value will be obtained in the midband. So next let us analyze the input side, which is shown in this particular figure. I am considering only this part, and here I am considering the equivalent capacitance CEQ. So if you observe, I have segregated this particular circuit and to find out CE equivalent. So at XX dash, if CGD is replaced by equivalent capacitance CEQ between the gate and the ground, as long as CEQ draws the current which is equal to IGD, then you can equate the diagram to this particular form. So I have SCEQ into VGS to be equal to SCGD into 1 plus GM RL dash into VGS, because what is CEQ? CEQ is equivalent is equal to CGD into 1 plus GM into RL dash. So that is denoted in equation number 4. From this figure, what we understand is that this figure is a single time constant STC circuit of a low pass type. So this single time constant circuits I will discuss in a different tutorial. So therefore the voltage, that is the output voltage of the CTC circuit, can be expressed in the form of equation number 5, which is given as VGS to be equal to RG divided by RG plus R signal into V signal, that is this voltage, multiplied by 1 by 1 plus S by omega naught, where omega naught is the corner frequency or the break frequency of the STC circuit. And this omega naught can be given as 1 by C in into R signal dash, which is denoted as equation number 6. So with C in is equal to CGS plus CEQ, we have C in to be equal to CGS plus CGD into 1 plus GM into RL dash, denoted as equation number 7, and R signal to be the parallel combination of R signal and RG, which we have seen here. Now combining the equation 1 and equation 5, that is again written here, this is equation number 1 and equation number 5, V out by V signal will give us minus RG by RG plus R signal into GM into RL dash, multiplied with 1 by 1 plus S by omega naught, denoted as equation number 9. Now this V out by V signal is actually equal to AM divided by 1 plus S by WH, where AM corresponds to midband gain, WH corresponds to the upper 3 dB frequency. So I can write AM to be RG divided by RG plus R signal into GM into RL dash, and that will give me the value of the midband gain. And this value WH is equal to W naught, which is equal to 1 by C into R signal dash, which is denoted as equation number 1, and FH is computed as W by 2 pi, and that will be equal to 1 by 2 pi C in into R signal. So from this frequency response plot, what we can conclude is that at high frequency, the response will be equal to that of a low pass STC, that is a single time constant network with the 3 dB frequency FH, which is determined by the time constant given by C in into R signal dash. So some of the observations that we have seen from the high frequency response and the equations, analysis of the equations, is that the upper 3 dB frequency is determined by the interaction of R signal dash to be equal to R signal parallel with RG and C in. And since the bias resistance RG is very large, it can be neglected. So what happens is that this R signal dash will be equal to R signal, which is the resistance of the signal source. So what follows is that if the value of R signal is very large, it will cause the value of high frequency FH to be lowered. Moreover, the total input resistance Cin is dominated by CEQ, which can be made large by the multiplication effect of CGD. So because this value of CGD is very small, the significant result will be that the total input capacitance Cin will be very large, and this will lower the frequency FH. So with whatever we have understood, we will try to solve the numerical. So we have been asked to find the midband gain AM and the upper 3 dB frequency FH for a common source amplifier fed with a signal source having an internal resistance R signal to be equal to 100 kilo ohms. The amplifier has an RG equal to 4.7 mega ohms, RD and RL to be equal to 15 kilo ohms, GM is 1 milli amps per volt, R0 to be 150 kilo ohms, CGS and CGD is given. One important thing to be noted here is when we considered the computation of high frequency response, we have considered the coupling capacitors and the bypass capacitors as short circuits. So when you see in these equations, you won't be able to find the coupling capacitors and the bypass capacitors. So because I've already dealt with the analysis, I have not given you the design, but the same equations are also available in this particular numerical. So first, to compute the midband gain, minus RG divided by RG plus R signal GM into RL dash. RL dash is the parallel combination of R0, RD and RL. That gives me a value of 7.14 kilo ohms. GM into RL dash will give me a value of 7.14 volt per volt. And AM can be computed as minus 7. CE equivalent is equal to 1 plus GM into RL dash into CGD. that gives me a value of 3.26 picofarad, and the value of total input capacitance Cin is equal to the sum of CGS plus C equivalent, that is equal to 4.26 picofarad. So finally, to compute the value of FH, that is the upper 3 dB frequency, I need to use the equation 1 by 2 pi Cin into RG parallel with R signal, that gives me a value of 382 kilohertz.